shalom from the Galilee Mountains. Some shade just to come under and come out from under the sun. Thank God I'm always in the sun, and He is the answer to all of your problems and mine. Put your faith in Yeshua today, which means God's salvation, and live for God, and now you're headed to heavenly places rather than the pit. You know, God loved us so much that He sent His one and only Son. And the scripture says that whomever should put their faith in Him shall never perish but have everlasting life. So our sin is the reason why we're separated from God, but Yeshua came in the form of a babe. He grew up to be the ultimate sacrifice. He is the Torah. He is the Word of God. The Torah is God's Word. It says in the Gospel of John, Yochanan, which was his name in Hebrew, this is the Hebrew Gospel, so to speak. All the first believers, early believers, were Jewish. Absolutely. The Mashiach is Jewish. Yeshua, the risen King, the spotless, pure, unblemished Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Pray with me today. Father, I realize that you sent Yeshua for me. He is my once and for all final atonement. There will never be another atonement. Thank you, Yeshua, for the blood that you spilt for me, because the life is in the blood, and that blood has redeemed all of my sin. It's redeemed my life. And the scripture says, I am crucified with Messiah. I no longer live, but He now lives in me. And the rest of my life, I live for Him. And that's ultimate freedom. And it breaks my heart, because people who have not received the Lord think that they're free, but they're actually enslaved to the devil. Because the devil and our flesh is like, it's a magnet. And we have no other choice but to serve our sinful nature if we have not repented of our sins and turned to Yeshua. And He wipes away our sin once and for all, and now we're headed for heavenly places. Not only that, but the scripture says that if you do not put your faith in the Son of Man, the Son of God, then you cannot please God. Yeshua said the works of God, it's two words, only believe. He said, whatever you ask in my name, I will do it to the glory of the Father, according to my perfect will. And then He continues and He says, and if you know that I hear, you know that I'm answering you. Keep seeking, keep asking, keep knocking, and it shall be done. I believe God does miracles, but for the most part, I believe that it's the prayer of the persistent saint, the one who's living is a righteous life in Yeshua. We can see something happen on the spot, but I think for the most part, it's because of what God wants to do in us, what He's building and refining in us. It's like the lumberjack. He keeps chopping and chopping and chopping at the root of the tree, and eventually it falls. And I feel like that's what it is with answered prayer. Will we stick close to God? Will we persevere in our prayers? Will we be persistent in petitioning the Lord? He wants a love affair with us that He'll never make us, because the greatest gift we have after Yeshua is free will. God wants us to come to Him on our own volition. He doesn't want to force us to love Him. He's not interested in that. So, Father, thank you for Yeshua. I receive Him to be my once and for all final atonement, and I will walk and dance with you for the remainder of my days. Shofar blow. God bless you from the Galilee Mountains. Walk with the King and dance with King Yeshua.